Is the American Civil Liberties Union doing its job as the court-appointed jail monitor in the L.A. County jails? Richard I. Fine has been ignored by the ACLU during his entire year of coercive confinement. But in January, Mr. Fine broke his dental plate and was unable to chew his meager jail food allotment. His situation was getting serious. Full disclosure, was unable to enlist the aid of the ACLU until they called Ed Asner.
What prompted you to go see Mr. Fine on January 25th?
I got a phone call from Ramona Ripston, who is the executive director, and she asked me to go see him.
I see. Did she say why she was asking you to go see him?
She had received a phone call from Ed Asner, like you said earlier.
Mm-hmm.
But they seemed unable or unwilling to help.
You said that the ACLU told you that they could not assist you with a court order?
That's right. They said that they could not do anything to get me the court order. And I said to them, well, basically, aren't you the ones that are supposed to really be helping me on this? And they said that they don't get court orders. And I sort of questioned as to what is their function if they can't get a court order. And they indicated that they really stop at just doing things with the jail. So it becomes sort of, it almost becomes a function that if they can't get the jail to do anything, then they're somewhat impotent.
Full disclosure took their cameras to the Southern California headquarters of the ACLU and interviewed Jail Project Coordinator Mary Tiedman and Peter Eliasberg, the managing attorney. They seemed to be confused about the complaints filed by Mr. Fine.
The fifth?
Yeah, the one that was filed on the 6th of January.
I think he got a response to that. I don't think that it was to his satisfaction, so there's an appeal process. But I don't know exactly which, I know he filed several, but the one that he was concerned about, that there was a long period of time, he showed me today that he had gotten a response.
Okay. Do you consider it a responsibility of your jail monitoring program to inquire about the status of complaints that inmates tell you that they've filed?
Yeah, we regularly follow up on complaints that we have filed because we track what we file and we ensure that there are follow-up, there's follow-up, and we'll sometimes follow up on the response that we get to make sure that it's sufficient.
Mr. Fine was less than enthusiastic about the ACLU's methods.
The ACLU coming in as the monitoring of the health part, sending a letter and saying if nothing happens within 10 days, to call them or contact them.
Your call may be monitored or recorded
at a telephone number that is blocked.
Did Mr. Fine tell you that he tried to reach you at the phone number that was given to him to call you?
Yeah, we talked about that. He was under the impression it accepted collect calls, and it does not, so that he had been trying to call it collect. And we don't accept collect calls right now.
Full disclosure pressed the ACLU representatives to see what they were doing to get Mr. Fine the dentures he needed to eat. Their confusion was perplexing.
Well, the next step is we're trying to figure out, because there seems to be some discrepancy between with getting him to physically see the dentist and get some impressions made on his teeth, and with what Mr. Fine told me today and what was my understanding from the jail regarding getting him to the dentist was a little bit different. So I'm trying to see what we can do to get him to the dentist.
The discrepancy, as he explained it to us in a collect phone call, we accept his charges, was that they have not yet to date offered to take an impression of his teeth.
Yeah, there was some kind of, I haven't been able to fully look into it because, like I said, I got back from jail about 2.5 hours ago, and I haven't been able to talk to the person at the sheriff's department I need to talk to because they weren't there when I contacted them. you know, what happened when he was taken to the clinic, why Mr. Fine didn't, you know, think he saw a dentist or didn't see a dentist, and why they thought he had refused to see a dentist. So
they thought he had refused to see a dentist?
Yes.
They're saying that to you?
There was some confusion about what was going on with his impressions.
It seems that rather than fixing the problems, the ACLU was serving as apologist for the sheriff's deputies in the jail.
I mean, my experience is sometimes the inmates are asked to sign stuff as to resolve complaints. It's on the sheriff's complaint form that the inmates sign that they have received follow-up on their complaint. And sometimes there's a little bit of, I don't know if confusion's the word, but there's some problems with when the inmates sign that something was addressed. And I think Mr. Fine wanted to have, or Mr. Fine was being, thought he was being asked to sign something before it was addressed. And so he was, he said he refused to sign the paper.
He's an attorney, isn't he?
But so I think that's what, that's based on my experience, that's the problem, but I don't know. I don't know fully all the, all exactly what the details are.
Mr. Elias Berg wasn't apologetic at all.
We try to provide the best service we can, but I know that lots of people come to us and hope we'll take their cases, and we don't for a huge variety of reasons. And they will, you know, occasionally I will then read on blogs or other places on the internet, the ACLU is useless. Well, we do a lot of cases, but we don't represent everybody, and we don't help everyone. We have their limits to our resources. So.
And still, Mr. Fine, who has never been convicted of anything, sits in solitary coercive confinement, unable to eat.
But if you take the ordinary inmate who does not have any assistance from the outside, the whole process of the ACLU turned out to be a joke.
Will the ACLU finally get motivated to help? Will the Sheriff's Department relent? Will Mr. Fine ever get justice? If you would like to see the entire full-length program, contact your cable operator station, or you can purchase the DVDs here at FullDisclosure.net. Full Disclosure will continue to bring you the news behind the news.